Wow, it looks like the Golden State Warriors are already making some moves, even though the season hasn't really started yet. The Warriors are pretty persistent on, kind of making these moves. We've seen in previous years that they've kind of illustrated these plans. Like, look, KD, where no one ever thought he was going to go to the Golden State Warriors, really, but again, apparently there was a plan for that even before the finals even happened, which is absolutely crazy to kind of think about that again as well. Now that the Golden State Warriors could be actually orchestrating something else, like the season's not even over, the playoffs are yet to start, but it is currently being reported that the Warriors could potentially be looking to package a deal that would include Kelly Oubre and Andrew Wiggins, or maybe it could be and or Andrew Wiggins, in exchange to potentially try and get DeMar DeRozan in the offseason. So again, that's actually coming from, a couple of kind of secretive reporters, those type of reporters that kind of saying these things might happen, but there's no real, like, 100% complete evidence that DeMar DeRozan is going to the Warriors, but there is evidence right now. It does seem we've had a couple of reports in the recent couple of months that the Warriors could be interested in, kind of DeMar DeRozan. And now there's kind of these other reports saying that the Warriors could actually package Andrew Wiggins and or Kelly Oubre, or maybe even both of them, to try and get DeMar DeRozan to the team. Now, I've spoken about this pretty vocally in my other video, which I highly recommend you guys go and check out. It's where I actually talk about potential free agents that I think the Golden State Warriors should, of course, go after. Again, I did actually make a separate video on that. Goes for about 20 minutes, I believe. So again, I'll talk about a couple of other free agents like Karl Anthony Towns. So if you guys would like to go check that out, I'll try and remember to link it in the description down below. If not, it should be uploaded potentially a couple of videos before this one does, of course, get uploaded. But again, with the Warriors kind of in the position right now, they do need to make a lot of moves in free agency. I believe this team is kind of, a glass half full or a glass half empty is kind of how, some people like to say it. And the reason why I'm saying this is because the Golden State Warriors brought in Kelly Oubre and was supposed to be, the big riser. Andrew Wiggins was supposed to have a pretty good season. He's had a decent season, but it's not like what a lot of people thought he could have had, being like a second option, second star type of player under Steph Curry. We also saw that, them getting in Kelly Oubre, they thought they were going to bring in a 17 point per game type of guy who could play great defense and hit the three ball at about 35%. We know that didn't really happen. He kind of came in and struggled from 3%, 3-point land pretty early on. James Wiseman has been incredibly disappointing as a rookie. A lot of people are, kind of saying they should have taken LaMelo Ball. Again, I actually also made a video talking about this type of issue. Some people are calling James Wiseman a bust. I actually made a video on this. I don't know if it will be out at the time of this video coming out. Probably not. But if not, stay tuned for that. It should be coming out very soon. But again, Draymond Green has had a fantastic year, in my opinion. Very underrated. Look, Draymond Green is averaging 7, 7, and 9. He's averaging literally 9 assists per game, which is absolutely crazy. And great defense. Look, he's not worth $25 million a year. That's the issue. That's why people don't really rate Draymond. Not because he isn't a good player. I don't feel like that. I think that his contract is so overpaid that people like to say that he's not a good player just because of that. But in fact, he is a really good player. He, again, 9 assists is pretty crazy. And he is really the main ball distributor on this team, in my opinion. Again, I know Steph Curry's the point guard, but I feel like Draymond Green's the main playmaker. And this is more evident in the assist total and the assist, per game. He averages a lot more than what Steph Curry does. But again, it is pretty crazy to kind of think about like that. Draymond Green is also their leading rebounds, probably their best defender. So again, they do have some moves to make. I feel like Draymond Green is going to be pretty safe on this team. They're going to trade him to how important he is to them. Klay Thompson will come back, hopefully fit and firing. And then they'll get, their center, James Wiseman, back from injury. He's going to be so much better next season, I guarantee it. But this is where they kind of, maybe need to improve. And the small forward position, they've got Andrew Wiggins right now. But I just don't know if I really rate Andrew Wiggins anymore. He's had his chances. I feel like Wiggins is that type of guy that the only way he's going to revive his career, improve, he's maybe worth $30 million, is if he goes to the team like the Rockets and be like the main guy. Like, I know Kevin Porter Jr. is supposed to be going to be that main guy pretty soon, and they've got Christian Wood. But Andrew Wiggins on the Rockets would be kind of cool. The Spurs are also in a similar situation to that, where if he was to go to the Spurs, I feel like he'd be the main guy. And under Coach Pop, who knows? Maybe this is the year Andrew Wiggins could actually break out if he was coached under Coach Popovich and actually learnt from him. Of course, he'd be that number one guy. I could see him averaging like 22 points plus per game. I think that'd be cool. So I'd probably, if I was the Spurs, I would take a gamble on Wiggins. I would honestly see what he can do. I think he on the Spurs would actually be pretty cool. And again, they can either lose DeMar DeRozan in free agency for free, or they can do a sign and trade. And if you're getting offered, who knows, maybe a couple of second round picks and Andrew Wiggins for DeMar DeRozan, or Kelly Oubre and Andrew Wiggins for DeMar DeRozan, then you're taking that every day of the week if you're the Spurs, because that is literally better than nothing. And you have a chance to turn Wiggins into, you know, something that we all know he can be. Look, he hasn't averaged 23 points in a long time since, I believe, the 2016-17 season, where he played 38 minutes and played about, or 32 minutes rather, and averaged about 24 points per game. I could see him doing that on the Spurs. Like, I mean, the team would be relatively built around him. It would be a pretty nice team. Like, he would just be taking over DeMar's spot. And DeMar right now is averaging 22 points and 7 assists per game. And I could see Wiggins having that type of year where he could average 23 points or something and like the 6 assists per game. Because again, Wiggins has shown he can play make. He did it in Minnesota, and I could see him doing it on the Spurs with DeJounte Murray. So that'd be kind of nice to see. But in my opinion, I don't really think the Golden State Warriors should go ahead with this. I think that, look, if to get rid of Andrew Wiggins, the only player you can get back, you know, that's any good is DeMar DeRozan, then go ahead, go do it. But if there are players, you know, like Karl Anthony Towns, who are reportedly potentially going to be, you know, up for trade, if you have to match contract, look, I know the Timberwolves won't want Wiggins back, but again, there's been reports that Karl Anthony Towns is interested in going and playing for Golden State. You'd have to trade James Wiseman a couple first, and to match the contracts up, you would probably have to put Andrew Wiggins in that deal. And honestly, Wiggins on the Timberwolves going back there would actually be pretty cool. But again, I don't think the Timberwolves would want to do that. But if they can get a couple first-round picks back in James Wiseman and a solid player like, you know, Andrew Wiggins for Karl Anthony Towns, you wouldn't think they'd kind of knock that one down. But again, I don't know. I feel like if DeMar DeRozan's the best you can get out of Andrew Wiggins in a couple of pieces, then he's probably the guy you're going to go have to get. But I don't know. I feel like he just plays a similar role to what Andrew Wiggins is playing right now. Look, of course, he'd be much more efficient than what Wiggins would be. Probably play better defense, probably still be a better playmaker. But again, do the Warriors necessarily really need that? I feel like they're in more needing of, like, you know, just a high scorer that can shoot the three-point ball. Because even though the Warriors have Steph Curry, their three-point percentage is not exactly the greatest. I mean, their spacing was really bad when they had Kelly Oubre kind of starting in that five. You know, now that they've moved Kelly Oubre, I believe they moved him even to the bench. I don't actually think he's starting anymore, if I'm right. Yeah, he actually hasn't started about five of those games. And they've kind of moved Kent Bazemore into that starting five now, where he's boosting that three-point percentage up. He's averaging 41%. I feel like if you can get a nice three-point shooter in like a Karl Anthony Towns, then that's the move. I don't know if you necessarily need DeMar. You've already got some quality mid-range players. And I guess, you know, getting back Klay Thompson, you would presume that your three-point percentage would go back. But Klay hasn't played in 2 years. Who knows how good he's going to be? Who knows if he's ever going to come back? He could injure himself again, which I really hope he doesn't. But there is still a chance, and it is something that we still have to very much consider and take into account. So it is, again, something that we should consider. But is DeMar DeRozan that guy? In my opinion, probably not. But if you can get rid of Andrew Wiggins for him, then I couldn't see why you wouldn't make this deal, especially considering that you might be able to get DeMar on cheaper. He's probably going to be on about $25 million a year, $20 to $25 million. I could see him taking a pay cut to go ahead and play for a contender. But it is going to be a really interesting one. Will the Golden State Warriors be interested in, you know, DeMar DeRozan? Will they, of course, go out and try and trade for him? Should they trade Wiggins? I definitely would like to know all of your thoughts and opinions on this down below. But of course, don't forget to subscribe to the channel for all the related NBA content and news. Don't forget to subscribe to my gaming channel, MIRL/Long Channels, if you haven't already. And don't forget to check out my podcast as well, if you haven't already. Links for them will all be in the description down below. But as always, I have to thank you guys so much for watching this video. Make sure to leave a like, subscribe, and comment. And I will see you guys next time. Goodbye. Through the wastelands, through the highway.